Leatherface. Because you can't, that name was already taken, kind of, but just do it again. Summary for this film: a teenage Leatherface escapes from a mental hospital with three other inmates, kidnapping a young nurse and taking her on a road trip from hell while being pursued by a lawman out for revenge. Directed by Alexandre Bustillo and Julien Maury. These people always work together. It's a weird IMDb page.
I see the Livid and Inside are two movies that I've seen of theirs. I like those.
Yeah.
I don't know what happened here.
They did a piece on ABCs of Death too. So,
yep.
And written by Seth M. Sherwood, who did the film Hellfest. I've heard a lot of good things about that. I don't know if it's
I like that movie.
Jason, do you have any details?
Yeah, tagline: witness the beginning of your end. Distributed by Lionsgate and on Blu-ray 2017.
Yeah, the end, all right.
Yeah, I mean, they'll make another Texas Chainsaw Massacre movie one way or the other, but this was not the start of anything. I don't know what they were doing with this. It sort of falls into this weird realm of shit I just really don't care about. I mean, the other prequel movie, I mean, it had a lot of shit most people don't care about. This one had nothing that anybody should care about. It was like,
that's all I can say.
Give me all the new Leatherface stories you want. Give them to me. I got time for them. I don't need an overwrought history lesson like this. It doesn't line up with anything I know of the character. And I'll be damned if I didn't think the wrong dude was Leatherface through most of this fucking movie. I don't know if that was on purpose.
No, it was. It's hard. They failed on that too. As soon as they put out the theatrical poster, it shows you which one's Leatherface.
Right.
Like, it wasn't even. He's not a fat dude.
Right.
Yeah, he should have been the long-haired dude. That guy was even moving like Leatherface. Shit.
That's what makes sense. I don't know. I don't know.
The whole so pissed off.
Trying to guess which one's Leatherface on a story about Leatherface seemed ridiculous.
But,
give me Leather right from the get-go.
That kid looked and moved like Leatherface, did not say much like Leatherface. The other kid's talking the whole fucking movie, running his mouth.
Right.
He might as well have been River Phoenix on Stand By Me as much as he was fucking talking.
Damn it.
and this movie, like 30 minutes in, I just still didn't care about anything that was happening. It was like watching a CW teen version of Texas Chainsaw Massacre or something. The people that try to do something outside of the Texas Chainsaw Massacre formula, I mean, good for you, but it rarely works. It's a real easy fucking thing to make these movies, I think. I mean, you just follow the recipe. It's like baking brownies. If you fuck around with a brownie recipe,
stick to the basics.
It's like making a nice chili, Frank.
Yeah, I mean, just get some people, throw them in at the house, and land them there somehow. Yeah. I don't care what it is. I don't care what the mulligan is or MacGuffin or whatever you want to call it to get them there. But... I don't know who this movie was made for. I like I said, I thought the wrong guy was Leatherface through until he got killed, until he got shot in the head. I thought the fat kid was him.
Like, well, that's not him.
I liked how they recreated the house from the original movie. This is the one where they actually like detailed the house down to, I mean, it was perfect. And I liked Stephen Dorff. I mean, but I always like Stephen Dorff. I even like him in those fucking commercials he was in for vape cigarettes.
Yeah.
Negative one. I'm tired of being a walking ashtray. Negative two. I'm tired of feeling guilty every time I want to light up. I'm Stephen Dorff. I've been a smoker for 20 years.
He's like the cool kid in high school.
I've liked him since The Gate, and I'll always like anything he does.
I love Stephen Dorff.
He was the best part of Blade, right? I mean,
yeah.
Explorer.
Yeah, I mean,
just recently, Frank, he was in True Detective on HBO. Yeah. And he was like winning awards and shit.
So. Yeah, he should. He deserves it.
Awesome.
I think this movie is shot beautifully. I mean, it's probably just the cameras, though. I mean, at this point, the money you throw at a camera can really do a lot. I give this a 5 out of 5. Nothing pays off. I am glad that the bad guys win.
5 out of 10.
Oh, 5. Oh, yeah, 5 out of No, 5 out of 5.
That's a perfect score.
No, but nothing.
Nailed it.
I do like how at the end they the bad guys win. Because this is where, like you wanted at the end of the last movie, Jake, a nurse or whatever she is, nun, what is she?
Yeah.
She gets her head cut off.
Yeah.
You know.
There's my spot.
So, yeah. Anyways, Jason, what do you say? You got a 5 out of 5?
No. Prequel to 74, again, this doesn't feel old to me. It doesn't feel like it's in the right time. I think it's cast well. I think the acting's solid. The production, cinematography, everything's there. Everything's done well. It has a good amount of gore. The practical effects look good. Has some cool death scenes, but it doesn't feel like a Texas Chainsaw movie to me. I wanted more Leatherface with chainsaw kills. It's like he took another back seat to a movie that is about him. Like that baffles me. Like there's always other strong characters. Like he's never really been like the out in the forefront through Texas movies. Like there's always characters like Chop Top and Drayton. Like they're up there. They help carry the movie themselves too. This one was supposed to be about Leatherface, and like I didn't get Leatherface. It's a 5 for me.
John Paul.
Well, Jason, I hated this movie.
There you go.
I really did. I didn't see this in the theaters. I tried to watch it 3 times and finally got through it. It was just
rough.
It was just boring. Yeah, it was shot well, like you said. And I think, Brake, you brought up, you totally nailed it. It's like a CW show. It's like instead of the one before this where they thought, oh, fuck, we got a course correct. They're like, well, no. Teens are watching these movies, so let's make it a teen type movie, and they failed miserably. It was just bad. Like you get some of the kills were cool, but man, did it suck.
Yeah, the curb stomping, or I guess it's not a curb, it's a rock.
Right.
That was really brutal. But of course, that was the guy I thought was the fucking Leatherface the whole time. But whatever. What did you give? What did you give it score wise?
What's the lowest I can give it?
I mean, do we do zeros?
I don't think we do zeros.
One, I guess.
Yeah, that's right in the Oregonian territory.
Oh my God! Now see, when you put those two movies, compare those two movies. Have you seen Oregonian?
A long ass time ago.
My God! Worst movie I've ever seen so far.
I still give it a 1.
Which was really bad from my perspective, but a lot of people love
levels. There's different levels of each number, so yeah, you can give it a 1.
All right, Ray, what do you say?
Yeah, I'm with you. I'm pretty much with the consistency on this. This is absolute garbage. Like Jason said, the movie's called Leatherface. It's not called Stand By Me as Let's Escape from Cuckoo's Mountain Nest. You know, One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest. It was nonsense. The everything about this except for Stephen Dorff, which I will give a tip of hat to, I liked his story, but this could have been a completely different movie. Didn't need to be Leatherface. Could have been kind of cool, probably. Bunch of nutcases break out and go on a killing spree. They get to a weird shack. They fuck each other over a dead body in the shack, which...
Yeah, that was a weird scene.
Weird scene went on for quite a while. I didn't know if I was going to be aroused or disgusted, but it was kind of a little...
It was like really licking that dead guy's face.
She's really getting into it, like licking the lips. And I was like, wow, I don't think... She's going over and above what I would do for $12.50 an hour, but hey, whatever. You know.
Yeah, they should have just called it Stand By Me, but with psychopaths.
Frank, I don't understand why the fat kid wasn't leather.
Doesn't make sense.
Doesn't make any sense.
It doesn't.
And then, they went out of their way to find somebody that looks just fucking like him.
Yeah. That's the thing that they want you to try to Yeah. Okay, they're the making it obvious. Like, you know it's not him, then.
It's the old switcheroo. For what purpose? It was fucking terrible. Had some great practical effects, I'll give it that. Like you guys said, shot beautifully. It looked, especially the daytime shots, looked cool. But at the end of the day, this movie was garbage on a level that I couldn't believe would be released with this name attached. So I'm going with a 4 out of 10.
Wow. Jake, what do you say? What's your score?
I'm also going to say 4 out of 10, simply because, you know, I'm Stephen Dorff. I actually, years ago, and thank God I still don't own it, bought this in the $5 bin at Walmart, simply because I thought it was like a knockoff Leatherface. Like, I thought by the name, since they didn't call it Texas Chainsaw Massacre, like that it was like a knockoff, like one of those like cheap fake movie versions. So I was like, oh,
like, this like Transmorphers or something.
Yeah, Transmorphers. Yeah, kind of like, yeah, a low budget one of those when they were doing the movies at dark series where like, yeah, people were making their own. So I was like, oh, maybe this is a completely different like movie, like they just happened to call it Leatherface.
Yeah, when I first heard about this movie, I thought they were just like updating part 3 Leatherface.
Yeah, like, so I just thought it was completely different. Like, then, it had nothing to do with the actual like Texas Chainsaw Massacre, and then it was like, oh, this is trying to be fucking no. So yeah, that's, yeah.
Well, we're gonna run out of time here, but I want
to. No, Frank. How much time we got?
We got
new trivia.
Okay, yeah, send the link back out.
Here we go. We'll take another little break. We'll be back.
I'm Leatherface.
Sorry, go on. Hey, that's a good movie. Now I just want to watch that. Idle Hands. Yeah. Good movie.
I love that movie.
Anyways, we'll be right back. Stay tuned.
Do your thing, cuz.
Hey, we're back. See how that works?
There it is. So, do you guys know the funny story about the production of this piece of crap?
Which piece of crap? Leatherface?
Leatherface.
No, what's that?
So New Line, and I'm sorry, Lionsgate was going to lose the rights to making these movies.
I thought we were going to be on another Platinum Dunes rant.
This is good old Lionsgate. They decided, you know, they wanted to retain the rights to this character, so they just threw this movie out, and that was why it's such crap.
Oh, it was just to keep the rights
to use it. Yeah.
If they don't go so many years without making a movie, they lose the rights to it, and so they literally had to throw one together.
Yeah. Which is why you get a $5 bin of this
movie. Yeah, exactly. Didn't even freaking know. Like, I wish I still had it, because literally nothing in the cover says that it's a Texas Chain. It just says Leatherface. Yeah.
Right. The whole rights thing is really weird, especially how sometimes, like, after a certain period of time, shit's just public domain unless you keep it up. That's why I think Night of the Living Dead is public domain now. I'm pretty sure. Which is weird that they're releasing. It's weird that they release, like, a Criterion collection when it's like, no, that's, we own that already. You should just give it to us, because everybody should just get one in the mail.
Yeah.